best.
Talk about Brooke Shields posing nude when she was 10 years old for Playboy. That when she was 12 years old, she played a prostitute.
Don't break the merchandise.
Hey, how do we know she is a virgin?
Have I ever lied to you before? Satisfaction guarantee.
I'll bid $100.
This is a man with a deviant plan.
In 5, 4, 3, 2.
You knew she was 13.
No, I didn't.
I've got the transcript right here. So this is funny.
You know, I get all this information about...
Instead of taking responsibility, he tries to blame it all on the decoy.
I was prepared for him to come after me, but I wasn't prepared for the person coming at me the way she came at me. She knew Bo. She knows me. I don't... Anyway,
it sounds like what you're trying to see is if you could score with a 13-year-old.
Look, every child out there is capable.
There's something I gotta tell you. I'm Chris Hansen with Dateline NBC.
Come on, man.
Hey guys, it's me, Comrade Lavender here, and today I'm about another deep dive political topic that I want to talk about. Today I want to do the deep dive video of Jeffrey Epstein, the victims of capitalism, and how capitalism is a safe haven for predators, a deep dive into this topic. So let's get started in this video. So yeah, my other YouTube videos related to this topic or similar to this topic will be on the screen right now if you'd like to check them out. So yeah, so let's get started on to the deep dive of this video. Capitalism is a predatory, psychopathic system that puts profits over lives of everything, the life of the earth itself, animals, and people. Capitalism is a safe haven for capitalist pig rich predators. Capitalism promotes gluttony and greed, with global inequality worsening due to capitalism, and basic necessities are becoming and being commodified. Workers endure horrendous working conditions while being underpaid, and vulnerable populations are illicitly bought and sold for non-consensual sexual services. Human trafficking is a booming business, now estimated to be over a $150 billion industry. Under capitalism, trafficking and exploitation thrive. Capitalism enables human bodies, especially those in vulnerable or unstable situations, to be profitable objects by those looking to exploit. Capitalism exploitation and human traffickers often hone in on these vulnerabilities, manipulating people and the victims themselves. With this grooming process, the targeted individual is reduced to the means of an end that will ultimately result in the exploitation and the trafficker's profit. This is what capitalism is. These traffickers use industries such as public transportation, hotels, motels, social media, and banks to aid in the recruitment and the continuation of trafficking. And while industries that intersect with human trafficking, like hotels and motels, are beginning to implement trafficking awareness employee training, many still intentionally turn a blind eye to the exploitation and fear of losing the business of the traffickers. Again, profits over lives under capitalism every day. Jeffrey Epstein was a billionaire capitalist pig and pedophile sex trafficker. He was very well connected and ran a capitalist pig sex human trafficking ring for the rich and elite and the bourgeoisie. He had a private plane called the Lolita Express, which in Japanese means Lolita, is a Japanese manga anime that is sexually explicit and involves cartoon characters that are underage. Remember, he named his plane after this. Jeffrey used the plane to shuttle underage sex trafficking victims to different cities in the United States. Regularly traveling with Epstein on the private jets was his wife, Ghislaine Maxwell, the billionaire's former girlfriend, who was accused of grooming and helping to recruit the underage girl for capitalist sex trafficking rings. In 2015, victim Virginia Roberts filed a lawsuit against the billionaire Jeffrey Epstein, claiming that he recruited her as a sex slave at the age of 15, sexually abusing her for years on his private jet. Her alleged abusers include the British royal prince, Andrew, as well as Harvard University law professor, Alan Dershowitz, and both of their names appear on flight logs obtained by the Daily Mail. Prince Andrew, who appeared alongside Roberts in a now-infamous photo taken at Epstein's Palm Beach mansion, has also strongly denied having underage sex with the teenager. Bill Clinton claims to have only traveled on Epstein's private jet 4 times, despite flight logs suggesting he was on board the aircraft as many as at least 12 times or more. Under capitalism, the entire criminal justice system, from the police to the courts to the prisons, is an arm of the state. They only serve the rich and elite and the bourgeoisie's interests. Money and wealth explain, you know, Epstein's crimes. How did he get away with these vile schemes for years under the noses of the police department, eventually escaping with barely a slap on the wrist? Because that's how the police and prisons work under capitalism. Anyone remember the Rebecca Zahow true crime case and how the police department was obviously engaged in a total cover-up? And when, you know, when she was clearly murdered, but the police kept saying it was a suicide.
Silkwood got into her Honda Civic and headed alone for Oklahoma City to meet with the reporter. Silkwood's body was found in a ravine in her car that had run off the road and was struck from behind. The car contained none of the actual documents that she had, which proves again that someone stole the documents because they were trying to do a catastrophic cover-up. You know, some journalists have theorized that Silkwood's car was rammed from behind by another vehicle with the intent to cause an accident that resulted in her death. Skid marks from Silkwood's car were present on the road, suggesting that she was trying to get back onto the road after being pushed from behind from another vehicle. Investigators also noticed damage on the rear of Silkwood's vehicle that, according to Silkwood, friends and family, Silkwood's family claimed to know of no accidents of any kind that Silkwood had had with the car, and that the 1974 Honda Civic she was driving was new when she purchased it, and no insurance claims were filed on the vehicle previously. Silkwood's relatives, too, confirmed that she had taken the missing documents to the union meeting and placed them in on the seat behind her, and they were missing, which proves it's a catastrophic cover-up, because documents don't go missing. They just said it was an accident. The police said it was an accident, but it's not, because you have to remember that the police work for Porky.
Jeffrey Epstein gave thousands of dollars to the police departments, but also Harvard University's, Ohio State science and technology institutions. He also used Capspig Media. He paid for press coverage and that have dream offers in front of the hungry Capspig Media journalists. They don't want the Shipley to rise up and start a revolution against the evils of capitalism. There's a reason why people like Epstein get away with this stuff and why people like Julian Assange are in jail and prison for exposing Capspig, you know, imperialist atrocities. Epstein was most likely murdered by the other capitalist pigs to keep him quiet. It might be a conspiracy theory, but it's not really that far-fetched if you really think about it, because again, profits over lives every day. Concerned about their own, you know, reputation, everyone from Bill Clinton, Donald Trump, to Prince Andrews have taken the time to make statements and excuses denying they knew anything about Maxwell's crimes or Jeffrey's crimes at all, and how they had no idea this was going on when they probably did. Who knows what the truth is, but one thing is for sure, the capitalist pigs don't want people to wake up and see the truth about the vile exploit system that is capitalism. That's why they push anti-communism propaganda campaigns so much and put sanctions on socialist countries. If you guys like this video, don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. Bye guys, see you next video.